Well, well, well. As I'm sure many of you remember, back in 2016, I got wind that a young BTT viewer had written his mother a heartfelt letter begging her to take him to see the new Deadpool movie. And she was in a tough spot because she really didn't feel it was appropriate viewing for him at his age. She reached out to me and I decided to start a campaign for a PG-13 additional cut. A lot of people missed that detail when I first did this, but I didn't want to get rid of an R-rated version of the film. I just wanted there to be an additional PG-13 version of the original Deadpool movie so that his younger fans could enjoy the show. And what do you know? 2 years and one Disney acquisition later, we're getting just that for Deadpool 2. Fascinating! Now, when I recommended the additional PG-13 cut, I felt that the way that Fox could do it at the time was have the PG-13 version playing in the earlier part of the day, and then the theaters could switch over to the R-rated version for the evening showtimes. And that way, Fox wouldn't have to book additional theaters. Now, at the time, I got a lot of support and coverage. The conversation really blew up. I got a couple of FUs from Deadpool's raunchier fans, but also some people pointed out that Hollywood doesn't really release two versions of a film simultaneously. The only example of that recently is when Harvey Weinstein cut a PG-13 version of The King's Speech, taking out a couple of swear words so that students, school groups could go and see the Oscar-winning film. But nothing at this scale. Well, fortune favors the bold, baby, and fortune is exactly what Disney and Ryan Reynolds are after. Well, I think more specifically with Ryan Reynolds, although I do think this would also equal more money for him, he'd love to be Team Disney. He wants to show that he's a team player. And Disney can do a lot more with a PG-13 character than they can an R-rated one. Think about it. This makes all the difference as far as I'm concerned. And I'm curious if any of you think it's worth the trade-off with the R rating so that you can have this become a reality. How'd you like to see Deadpool in the theme parks? How would you like to see him immortalized as a Disney theme park ride? With his face covered, Deadpool would be an amazing animatronic. He could do a ride with meta commentary. That would be so fun for Ryan Reynolds and quite the feather in his career cap. And so you can't do any of that without a PG-13 rating. Could they split it, as I suggested just earlier in this video, and have the PG-13 version of the film earlier in the day and then an R-rated one in the evening? I think if Disney had their choice, they'd like to fully transition Deadpool over to a PG-13 character, but that could really upset a large part of the Deadpool fan base that's grown. So the split might be something that they could maybe do down the line. But anyway, I think Ryan Reynolds is like, this sounds pretty good to me. And so Fox, well really Disney, has a PG-13 test lined up for this holiday season that we now have the full details on that's still very authentic to the character because Ryan Reynolds is fully on board. So Once Upon a Deadpool is a PG-13 version of Deadpool 2 with additional footage that was shot all in one day with Fred Savage, a clever take on The Princess Bride, which is a Fox movie, and come to think of it, also a pretty good acquisition for Disney, that brand. Anyway, with the additional footage that they shot with Fred Savage, but also I'm sure some of the additional footage that made up the alternate cut that was already on the Blu-ray release, they shot so much stuff that a lot of it ended up on the cutting room floor, so they're going to take all that, like in a snow globe, shake it up, and they're hopefully going to rain down money. Because think about it, it's safe to say there's enough new material here to satisfy parents, and maybe even pique the curiosity of other moviegoers who've already seen Deadpool 2. You're like, maybe I should check it out. There might be enough new stuff there to make it worth the ticket price. Now, the PG-13 version, also to make you feel like you really gotta go, is a limited engagement for the holidays, starting December 12th and playing only through Christmas Eve. How nice is that? So many people like to read the night before Christmas, before Santa comes, right? Wouldn't it be great to maybe go and make this something you do this holiday season, that you go see Once Upon a Deadpool? He's wearing a Santa hat, as you can see from this promotional image with the Fred Savage stuff. And this might be a chance for parents to spread some Christmas cheer to Deadpool's littlest fans, finally saying yes to the movie that they previously had to say no to. Now, I'm sure some of you are like, but Grace, when I went to see Deadpool 1 and 2, there were a lot of kids there. Well, I bet there were more kids at the first for the first movie because I know that a lot, because, you know, traditionally there are R-rated movies do have a lot of families go here in the United States, but that's usually because they're rated R for violence. Take a movie like Logan. It had one topless shot. And I think for that, parents, are okay. But sexual innuendo becomes a big problem. And many of you told me when the first Deadpool movie came out that you were seeing walkouts with parents with kids, particularly at the International Women's Day joke in the film. And I think that because the box office for the sequel didn't grow as sequels are supposed to, I think you can realistically account that to families sitting the sequel out, being like, you know, now I know what's actually going on here. And I know a bunch of you are going to be writing down below about how puritanical America is, but you know what? We're the biggest box office in the world, so you just got to deal with it. Now, if you're still on the fence about this whole thing, something else to get you to buy a ticket is that $1 for every ticket sold will go to charity, specifically F Cancer, which has been renamed hilariously Fudge Cancer for this event. And remember, Wade Wilson as a character actually has cancer. So this isn't only a good deed, but it's brilliant synergy. When Ryan Reynolds comes on board, he really comes on board. So December 12th, by the way, is a Wednesday, and that gives it even a little bit of a head start in front of the Spider-Verse movie. So while there's plenty of competition at theaters this holiday season, I think the chance for tots to finally taste the previously forbidden fruit, and for parents to be a hero and get a few new laughs in the deal, I think this movie could still make an impressive dent at the holiday box office. Even if Once Upon a Deadpool just breaks double digits overall, we're talking just over 10 million, I think it would prove a very potential way forward for the character at Disney, and again at Disney beyond the box office. So what are your thoughts on this now that we have a clear picture of what's going on? Will you be willing to sacrifice Deadpool's R rating for more Deadpool across the Disney empire? Think of the legacy of the character. They would be able to sell Deadpool stuff at the Disney store. I don't know, again, if you could do that with an R rating. Will you see this movie? And if you are going to go see it, are you part of the group that maybe had to skip Deadpool too, or at least couldn't take the kids because of that R rating? And have you told them yet that you'll be taking them to see this new Deadpool? And what are their reactions? Share your thoughts down below. And of course, as always, you can check out some more videos right now.